Alright guys, still letting the 125 warm up. We'll just poke around right here in the parking lot. Let it get warm. It went from so warm to now it's cold. Got my sweatshirt on this other side, because I was pretty sure that this was all supposed to be closed off, but there's such a trail going down into it now that obviously they know people ride down here. Nobody's closed this off. They haven't done anything to keep people out, so is this an actual riding area now? Part of the trail? It went anywhere, but I've seen so many tracks coming down here. I thought, what the heck are everybody doing down here? Just one bowl? Come down and go back out? Interesting. Cold air is coming in over the mountains. They're expecting snow Thursday and Friday to hit up here in the mountains. So today's Wednesday, so that coldness is already coming over the mountains. almost 80 yesterday, like 75. To, I don't know, it's gonna be 49, 50 today. Take 1 minute right down here before we take off and try and loosen my hands up a bit. Oh. They are a little tight already. Apparently I'm gonna roll. So there we go. That worked. Oh. From yesterday, I'm pretty sore today. Doing all those laps on the mini track, which you guys didn't see, but I did a 30 minute moto, 15 minutes in one direction around the little track and then 15 minutes the other way. I may not have quite made 30 minutes, it may have been 25, but by the time I was done, I was sore, and it was pretty interesting to ride it in reverse. today. Oh my goodness, my neck is frozen. funny because on this versus like my 450, it's so much like being a surgeon with a scalpel or just using a big fucking hammer. So on the 450, it's just like having a big ass hammer. Like anytime you see rocks or anything, you just lift your front tire through them, and just the only way to really get through it good is to, you know, give it gas and keep the light burning light. For this thing, it turns so good, you can put the front tire right between all the biggest rocks and walk it right through, and the suspension's so good that you don't even really have to work at it. It's pretty big difference. Pretty amazing difference. I don't know what's faster or what one that I ride faster, but it certainly is a big difference in the riding. And I like both of them. Sometimes I like to just hammer down and lift the front tire. Sometimes I like to be a technician and get through the little tiny lines and, you know, be precise. This stuff doesn't look like it's melting much. Not much at all. Bummer. This right here that I drove through looks better. Come through and plow some of that snow out of the way. Maybe it makes it easier next time, huh? I noticed where we came through yesterday melted out a bunch compared to what it was before we came through, so. We'll just keep melting tracks through all of this. Old Dunlop traction for days.
Mm-hmm.
A little different downhill than it was uphill. Swinging snow everywhere. Love it. Love it. Spencer and I. First little loop up and to the snow, done. It's a little cold out here, the boogers are freezing. I have to take care of that. All right, boogies dealt with, glasses wiped off. We're good. Get the show pony back on the road.
Yeah.
couple days on road, and I just ended up looking over my shoulder, going, what the crap? Nobody's there. But it sounds like a big four-wheeler or a big dirt bike. Kind of like my cousin 650. This hasn't dried out much. I feel pretty good on the tight stuff today. Oh, 125, you know, 125 do. And make tight wood look silly. Better do my obligatory wheelies. Always do wheelies here. Always. There's a couple good rocks and whatnot to get the front wheel pumped on. On this thing, I'll tell you that much. This thing just doesn't have the same response that my four strokes do, so it's just different. Not bad, just different. Yeah. almost got too much front brake on that one. Almost. I do fine with the front brake until I'm trying to give it a little to the throttle and have some brake, and then it's all over. My throttle hand ends up giving it more brake, and then that's too much brake, and which would lead you to ask, why would you be on the brakes and the gas at the same time? I don't know why, it just happened. And he told me what a huge mistake I was making running caster and trail bike, and oh my goodness, it's just gonna clog up so bad and junk up everything. I'll be rebuilding my bike in 50 hours or something, 40 hours, whatever he said. It was gonna mess up the ring and make it where the ring didn't work, and what an idiot I was for doing such a thing. I just had to laugh at him. What difference is pinned on the fucking trail or pinned on the track? If he thinks I'm out here riding trails, like trial bikes? No. I don't ride trials. Maybe that's what the problem was. He thought I was riding trials on my 125, not trails. This thing up and abuse it anymore on a motocross track than I can out here. And maybe some people don't ride trails on their two strokes like this, but I'd much rather. It's way funner when I hear people putting around all the time in their woods on their two stroke and they never hit the pipe for an entire ride. I'm sad. You're not hitting the pipe on a two-stroke. Why the fuck do you have a two-stroke? Oh, but they let down so great. Yeah, without the whole ass on the pipe, you should try that. But Randy, I bought a 300. It's way too much power if you hit the power band. Once you hit the pipe, it's just uncontrollable. No shit, Sherlock. Boy, CR500s are not exactly known to be woods bikes, right? A little too much oomph for riding trails. To ride on the pipe through tight stuff. But literally, if you're not riding a two-stroke on the pipe, you will end up junking it up, fouling it up, getting a bunch of buildup on everything because it's not being ran hot, hot and hard. I don't have any worries whatsoever about my bike getting all junked up because I'm not revving it enough on the trail. See if we can make it to the bottom this time. Last time we couldn't quite get to the bottom. I'm hoping today we'll make it clear to the bottom. Oh jeez. A bear or something must have torn that up. That was a bear right there. This wasn't here yesterday. I almost guarantee you a bear pulled that down, getting the bugs and stuff out of it. I don't see any prints at the moment or any poop, but I bet you. Little bridges have been here since last year. Got us a pass through, but very tight. Thank you, solid people. take my front tire over that if it wasn't snow, but it'd be interesting with the car. Dang it. I don't know if I can put these back on, but at least I'll get them on my helmet. Having them on the bars always sucks. Bigger. Goggles. That air is cold. Dunlop 33s are really sold or renowned for their snow prowess, but they've been doing good. They're making it happen. Ship down, fool. I'm glad whoever this was on the four-wheelers were motivated, because if they wouldn't have been able to come through, then I wouldn't have. They gave up on me! Where'd the trail go? Them suckers. They could have made it a lot further. Of course, I have no idea what day they were up here playing, but... Darn it! That's as far as we go, I guess. I think the trail wanders out and through, but this is where it ends for us, are they? You know, take a pee and turn around, and we'll get it out of here. All right. Got it whipped around, and see if we can get up out of here. Might be more interesting going up and out than it was coming in. Might as well, I'm thinking about it. Get these things back on. Only takes 3 seconds and one kick. And we're back at it. Like nothing ever happened. Melted out, but trying. Directional control is better, a general idea. Maybe I have it in seconds. Yep, I did. Come on, baby. I know. I'm so mean to you. You did great, though. any hard enduro, but you guys got a little bit of it. One tiny little hill crossing, a little bit of snow hopping. Now back to Whitten. Thank you. for the ownership. Yank the front end up. But at the same time, if you're not in the power and you try and do a pop and don't give it enough oomph, then it doesn't pull the front end up. So, catch 22, right? Trying to find that just right forage. Not too hot, not too cold, but right in the middle. That's a lot of what we do on dirt bikes, isn't it? Try and find the forage. whatever you want to call it. Boring. That would have been good if I would have stayed on the pipe. Too much boring. Had to lift off of it. That one felt pretty good. Controlled. Came up to a point and I didn't want to continue. A balance point by any means. I am not a balance point really guy. I'm working on it. This thing's a whole different thing. I'd almost gotten good at my wheelies on my 450. My 250's pretty okay, but this thing's a whole different world. You pretty much have to use a clutch pop to get it to go, unless you use the suspension too, but I don't. Not trying to do it that way, but I'll get it. Practice makes perfect, right? Couple 4,000 more wheelies, 4,000 more miles, 4,000 more gallons to the gas tank. I'm so far behind so many of the guys I race with that have been racing and riding for 20, 30, 40 years. Guess not 40 years, because we're all 40 years old, but 20 to 30 years of riding and 10, 20 years of racing. Got a lot of making up to do. This is my fourth year riding. Fourth year riding, third year racing. As an adult, we rode when we were kids, but a 125 three-wheeler with balloon tires and no suspension isn't exactly the same. Poor bike is like, dude, did this guy fall off? Like, we're just rolling down the hill? What the hell? Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
can't turn, just go straight. Always works. Days I gotta get my buddies to come riding with me and have somebody jump on my 250. little bit of a thing. Maybe not too much as you've done before. Did we have fun? Absolutely. Tell you what, guys, a couple of my first little short videos and stuff I did, I got a little extra views than I normally would because I was able to boast and say, you know, 270 pound guy, 125, can I get up the hill, make it, does it have enough power, can I moto with it? Well, this thing's fucking me up because I enjoy riding it so much and I get out and ride so much that I went and jumped on the scale the other day and I'm down to 250. So now all my claims about being a big fat guy, I can't even make those videos anymore. But on a serious note, guys, I'm loving this bike. It's everything I wanted for up here in the tight woods and playing around with it. I don't see what people could even complain or say about having a kickstart. It's so robust on the bottom end, being the X model, that I don't hardly ever stall it unless I'm like today in the deep snow or screwing around doing hard enduro stuff that I do not have the skills to do. But as far as just riding it, I only kickstart it when I fuck with my goggles or whatever, and even then I could take extra time, put it in neutral, and I don't even have to kickstart it again. But it's literally no thing. All these people want to make a big deal about not having an electric start. I think your opinion is garbage. Bike is awesome. Carburetor runs great once you get it jetted right, once you get it jetted for where you live and how you like to ride. Everything else works great. I still have not checked the tire pressures on either front or rear since I bought it. Whatever they put in at the factory, or at the dealership I should say, I've just left it that way, haven't messed with it. The maintenance that I've done to it, you guys have seen. Air filter once, gear lube twice, and that's it, really. Put on some handlebars and whatnot because I like them, but as far as maintenance wise, that's it. I'm a rear brake abuser, as most of you guys who watch all the time know, and you can see there the rear brakes are looking great. It's a little hot, but they're wearing perfect. I don't see, you know, that's going to be another 30-40 hours before I have to change those, so that's awesome. I don't ever use the front brakes, so I don't imagine they have any wear at all. The tires are holding up pretty good. These are MX34s, front and rear. Pretty sure, yeah, 33. MX33 front and rear, not 34s. They're not the newest style. They're the one step back, but none of the lugs have torn yet. It looks like there are a couple little marks on a couple of them, but none of the lugs are tearing. Wearing really good. Same with the rear. It's got a tiny bit of wear on the roundness of the bites. But other than that, nothing tearing, nothing bad. Everything's just doing great, guys. I've only got, I think yesterday it was 15 hours. I got 19 hours on it. Hopefully you guys can see that. 19 hours, and it's been flawless so far. I know kind of all bikes are flawless when they're really new, so we're gonna keep putting the hours on it, and I'm gonna keep enjoying riding this bad boy, and we're gonna keep having fun, keep learning. Hope you guys enjoy it. Later. It just gets bigger and bigger. back to the other trail. Maybe. Or maybe not. Oh my goodness. I'm not gonna plow through all that. We made it a little further.